Maxpurs presents Bizarre Wedding Rituals from Around the World. Number 1. Blackening of the Bride. Most brides want to look perfect and beautiful on their wedding day. If you are a bride in Scotland, you won't look perfect all day due to this bizarre wedding tradition. On their wedding day, the bride and groom are bound with tape and adhesive. Next, they have food and trash thrown at them. It's believed that if the couple can withstand this together, they can withstand anything. Number 2. Spitting on the bride. In most places around the world, if you spit on someone, it is a huge sign of disrespect. If you are a bride in Africa, you should expect to be spat on. In Maasai tradition, it is considered to be respectful to be spat on. Because of this, the bride's father will spit on her head and then her breasts as a sign of respect. This would not be acceptable anywhere else in the world. Number 3. Kissing the bride and groom. At the end of a wedding ceremony, the bride and groom kiss. If you're getting married in Sweden, tradition says that you will need to do a lot more kissing before you finally get to kiss your new spouse. According to Swedish tradition, before the couple says, "I do," all of the men at the wedding are allowed to kiss the bride, and all of the women are allowed to kiss the groom. This could be a huge problem if the bride or groom are jealous types. Number 4. Beating the groom's feet. If you are a groom in South Korea, your wedding day isn't going to be all happiness and fun. According to South Korean tradition, the guests at the wedding beat the groom's feet with a stick. In some cases, they beat his feet with dry fish. The ritual is painful, however, it doesn't last long. Each guest gets only one whack. All a South Korean groom can do is hope for a very small wedding. Number 5. The Money Dance. There is a Polish tradition that can help the bride make some money on her big day. According to the tradition, the male guests pay to dance with the bride. The groom stands on the sidelines watching his bride dance with the other men at the wedding for money. If the guest list is big enough, the couple can make enough money to pay for their honeymoon. Number 6. You can't use the bathroom for 3 days. The Indonesian Taidong community has a very strange and potentially gross tradition. After the bride and groom say, "I do," they are not allowed to use the bathroom for 3 days straight. It is said that couples who don't follow this tradition will have bad luck. After the food and drinks at the reception, it makes you wonder how many couples have accidents during these 3 days. Number 7. The Bridesmaid Blockade. In China, the groom cannot marry his bride until he makes it through the bridesmaid blockade. This is where the friends of the bride get together and create a protective barrier between the bride and the groom. They set certain imposing conditions that the groom needs to undertake before he can reach his bride and marry her. This tradition is in place to test the groom's love for his bride. Number 8. The Crying Ritual in China. The Tujia people of China have a very strange wedding tradition. It's actually one of the most bizarre wedding rituals in the world. Starting 1 month before the wedding, the bride must cry for an hour each day. Oftentimes, her mother and her friends will join her as well in crying. This tradition can make for one very puffy-eyed bride on the day of her wedding. Number 9. Marrying a Tree. There are some women in India that are considered cursed. If they were born when both Mars and Saturn were under the seventh house, they cannot marry until they go through a very strange ritual. These women are called Manglik. Before these women marry their groom, they must marry a tree. If they don't, their new husband will suffer a premature death. The women look very silly marrying a tree, but it must be done if they're going to live a long life with their husbands. Number 10. The French Toilet Tradition. This is a relatively disgusting tradition created by the French. The tradition requires that the bride and groom drink all of the leftover alcohol from a toilet bowl. Over the years, the tradition has not been practiced as often, if at all. Many French couples are obviously happy about this, since dogs are the only ones who are happy when drinking from a toilet. Number 11. A whale's tooth as a gift. If a man is going to get married in Fiji, he needs to be very brave and a good swimmer. Before the wedding, the groom must give his bride a whale's tooth as a gift. He's not allowed to go online to find one on eBay either. He is required to dive hundreds of feet into the water and face the largest mammal on Earth. Once he finds a whale, he needs to find a way to pull one of the mammal's teeth out. Unless he does this, he will not be able to prove that his love for his bride is real. Number 12. The graveside wedding. This isn't exactly a wedding tradition. It is more of a venue option that many couples take advantage of. They are allowed to visit the tomb of the unknown soldier in Moscow, Russia, and they can get married right by the grave. It makes you wonder what couple would want to get married beside a depressing tomb. However, it is very popular in Russia. Number 13. Love spoons in Wales. There is a Welsh custom that is very strange. Before a man can marry a woman, he must give her a very meticulously crafted fancy spoon. When he gives it to his bride, he tells her that he will stay with her and feed her for life. The idea behind this custom is sweet, but still a bit strange. Number 14. Greek wedding traditions. According to Greek customs, the bigger the wedding, the better. Like many weddings around the world, Greek couples who get married dance their first dance together. Unlike many other traditions, however, the bride and groom are not the only ones on the dance floor during the first dance. During the first dance, the guests pay the groom and they pin money on the bride's dress. This custom is considered to be an honor for the guests, even though it will cost them. Number 15. The Big Bride. Many brides start dieting a year before their wedding so that they can fit perfectly into their wedding dress. This is not the case in Mauritania. Here, the bigger the bride, the better. This isn't just an idea, it is a custom. The bride starts gaining as much weight as possible before the wedding. When the wife is overweight, it signifies that the man will be able to provide more than enough for his family. Subscribe for more.